Inside the Kelsey Museum at the University of Michigan, there is an exceptional collection of ancient remains from the Roman-era village of Karanis in Egypt.
Karanis was a Greco-Roman town primarily. They were interested in it because it was a breadbasket. It could provide wheat and barley to feed the populace of Greece and then Rome. It was first excavated by the University of Michigan from 1924 until 1935. The whole site of Karanis has tremendous potential. It is an absolute treasure of an archaeological site. It's still being excavated today.
When people tend to think of items from ancient Egypt, they think of gold and they think of mummies and they think of pharaohs, but the stuff that was collected from Karanis was just everyday objects that normal people and farmers and their families would use. So we have glass, we have pottery, we have sandals, we have coins. Francis Kelsey had a deal with the Egyptian government that Egypt would keep half of everything that was discovered and Michigan would bring the other half home. And so that's why we have so much here to study. There's a huge variety. We have lentils, we have peas, we have cabbage seeds, we have wheat, barley, we have bulbs of garlic, and then there's a ton that we haven't even identified yet. So part of what we're going to be doing on this project is figuring out what it is and identifying it and seeing how broad the diet of Karanis really was.
The grains are important because we don't really have samples, very large samples, of ancient grains, ancient fruits, ancient vegetables, ancient animals. The samples of Karanis give us a window into the past, the nutrient content of some of these plants. I'm overseeing a lot of the archaeozoological work at Karanis, and that is the animal bone remains and the animal aspect of it.
Working alongside a team from Belgium, supported by an international grant, the project will shed light on ancient diet and farming practices that can help modern-day agriculture techniques in arid, dry regions.
We are going to test the nutritional profile of ancient crops and animal bones. So we are looking at the crops, identifying them, reconstruct ancient agricultural systems. So, you know, the agricultural practices that produce those crops and animal husbandry. And we are also going to select some of these grains for radiocarbon dating to have a much more precise idea of when these crops were cultivated. At the end, what we want to achieve is to have a more nuanced idea of ancient diet, to have more information about the nutrition of the staple food. The results of these studies are going to be important also for modern food issues. The pilot study showed that the ancient grains are much, much more nutritious or nutrient-rich than the modern counterparts. And also, they are adaptable to extreme environment and extreme salinity, so they will require less water. That is one of the issues of modern agriculture. There are no other collection like this outside of Egypt available for this kind of research, and that is why this collection are important.